Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's tilt. Should preamble by saying that I'm doing a 1994 replay of the Montreal Expos season. 1994 was the season of the strike, no series, no completion of the season, and the Montreal Expos ended up, you know, essentially getting kicked out of going to the playoffs and potentially the World Series. So I'm replaying that season. We're in game 100. Which is the third game of a three-game set with the Atlanta Braves. Braves are a good team. They're the team of the 90s. And in the replay, the team's records indicate the only thing that changes about Atlanta's record is how they performed against Montreal. And in this case, they have won two more games than they would, or they did in the regular season of 1994. So, entering this third game of the contest, there's a two-game differential. The Expos have won 64, Braves have won 62. Today's game pits Kent Merker, first time that the Expos have met Merker in the 94 season, versus Ken Hill. Ken Hill in replay is 11-4, ERA is mid-3.5s, has had an issue with giving up the long ball. And he is 1-1 against Atlanta with an ERA of 4.25. So not fared overly well against the Braves. This being his third start. I'm going to give you the starting lineups first of all. Montreal, Marquise Grissom leads off playing center field. Will Cordero is the second batter at shortstop. Moises Alou bats third playing right. Larry Walker, first baseman's cleanup hitter. Rondell White is the left fielder, batting fifth. Lenny Webster is the catcher, batting sixth. Mike Lansing is the second baseman. He is batting seventh. Sean Berry is the third baseman, batting third. And the pitcher, of course, then Ken Hill. The Braves send to the plate their starting lineup today. Leading off and playing center field, Roberto Kelly. Batting second, shortstop, is Jeff Blauser. Batting third and playing left field is Ryan Klesko. Batting cleanup, the crime dog, Fred McGriff. Playing first base, Dave Justice, right field, batting fifth. Terry Pendleton playing third, batting sixth. Javi Lopez is making the start at catcher today. He is the seventh batter. And Mark Lemke bats eighth, with the pitcher Merker batting ninth. The first two games, the Montreal Expos won the first game, 6-4, in comeback fashion. They were down 4-0 and scored 6 runs in the last 2 innings, highlighted by a blown save by Steve Bedrosian. Starting pitcher was John Schmoltz, who had handled Montreal in 2 previous outings. In this outing, he had tired in the 8th. Bedrosian came on, and long story short, they scored 5 in that 8th inning to take the game. Second game was Greg Maddux was the starter for Atlanta. Butch Henry went for Montreal. And Atlanta built a 6-0 lead, again based on home runs, in this case McGriff and Charlie O'Brien, the catcher for Atlanta. Atlanta did come back, scored, the final score being 6-4. The 8th frame ended with the bases loaded, Will Cordero now facing Steve Bedrosian in relief of Maddux, and hit a fly ball to the base of the fence with the bases loaded. Cordero had had 2 previous grand slams in the replay, so an exciting finish for that inning. Bedrosian, essentially after a leadoff double in the ninth, retired 1-2-3, and Atlanta took the second game. So we're going to get underway. Merker's done with his warm-up tosses, and Marquise Grissom is in the bat. Roll is 3-5 against a left-hander. He struck him out. Will Cordero will bat. Again, shortstop. Pitch Cordero is a 6-8 versus right-handers. That's a ground ball to third. Pendleton has it. Over to McGriff. Two are down. Two up and two away. Moises Alou. Alou's hitting north of 350 in the three play. He's hit some timely home runs, including one in the first game of the series off the Grosjean net. Essentially put that game away. Lefty versus righty. 212 on Moises Alou's card is a hit by pitch with injury. In the replay, I simply take the player out for the game should an injury occur, because I'm using the lineups established back in 1994. So, but that does take Moises out of the game. I'm going to put Lou Frazier in his place. You know, second thought, since we've got a lefty on the field, or on the mound, excuse me. I'm not going to do that. Chances are pretty much limited here, so I am going to go with Cliff Floyd is going to take over. Floyd is going to play first base, and Walker will move to right field. So Floyd is in, playing first. Running for Alou, and now the right fielder, Larry Walker, comes to play. Lefty versus lefty in this matchup. They're two out, a man on, top of the first. 6-6 is a split double, 1-6 fly to center. The rest of the way, the split is 11. Fly to center is the result, and they're three out. No runs, no hits, no errors. There's a man left. Nothing across for the Expos in the first. The Braves are coming to bat. Ken Hill will face Roberto Kelly, Jeff Blauser, and Ryan Klesko. Ready versus righty. The result is 6-5, which is a ground ball to short. Cordero over to now first baseman Floyd. Out, one away. Jeff Blauser is the batter. Righty versus righty in this scenario. 1-5 is the result, which is a strikeout in Blauser's card. Hill got him on a changeup. Brian Klesko is the batter. Klesko's got some decent power. Gets right-handed pitching. The result is 5-9, which is ground ball to second base. Second baseman Lansing is up with it. Over to Floyd. Side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left in that first inning. Fourth inning of one is no score. Rondell White getting the start in left field today against the left-hander Merker. Pitch to White. The result is 2-7, which is a single one. Line out the rest of the way. Lines up to Pendleton. One out. Lenny Webster. Been wearing out left-handed pitching. It's a catcher result. 10. I believe it's going to be a split. It is. Javier Lopez is a 4 and a 2. Roll a 7, it's a chopper out in front of the plate. Javi gets it, fires from McGriff, there are two away. Two up, two down. Mike Lansing, the batter. Lefty versus righty, lefty pitcher, righty batter. Bounce to second base. Lemke has it. Side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left in the second for the Expos. Bottom of the second, no score. McGriff, Justice, and Pendleton are the batters scheduled for the Braves. McGriff homered in that first game. He homered in the second game, too. See if keep them off the board in the third game. 6-8 is the result, which is a double 1 through 10, single the rest of the way. The split is a 13, so McGriff leads off the second with a single. Not much of a threat to steal. He's a C stealer, 1 to 11 chance. That grows to 1 to 13. Hill is a plus 2 as far as holding, and Webster's throwing is a plus 1. So they elect not to run, give Justice a chance to swing with the base, with a man on base, and Justice lines a base hit right just off the second baseman's glove. No further advance by McGriff. He stops at second. The runners at first and second. Nobody out. Pendleton the batter. He's batting left. Switch hitter batting left against Hill. Potential for a bunt here. He's a C bunter. Corners are in for the Expos. Preventing that bunt, he's swinging away and hits a 6-9, which is home run 1-4, triple the rest of the way, and the split is a 4, so a 3-run homer by Pendleton here in the second. Puts the Braves up 3-0. Good thing he ignored the bunt sign. Javi Lopez is the batter now. Nobody out. Bases are clear now with a homer. Pitch to Lopez. It's a 6-8, which the result there is double 1-2, single the rest of the way. Split is a 14, so Javi singles. Four straight Braves have reached base now against Hill. Mark Lemke the batter. Switch hitter batting left. Pitcher's on deck. Pitch to Lemke. The fly ball to left field. Shallow. Left fielder White comes in and makes the catch. There's one away. Kent Merker is a left-handed batter. A 1, so he's not much of a batter. And a D bunter, so not much of an opportunity there to move Lopez up either. Swinging away. The result is 4-5 against the lefty. It's a bounce to short. Shortstop is a 3 for Expos. Will Cordero is a 3 and a 33. Split is a 10, so it goes to the X board. The result is 9, which is ground ball A to short. So Cordero to Lansing to Floyd, double play. Pitcher bounces into a double play. But they get 3. 3 big runs on 4 big hits. No errors, nobody left. The Braves lead after 2, 3-0. Current standings, the Expos are 2 games ahead of the Braves. They've split the first 2 games of this series. They remain at that 2-game differential. And now, with the rubber match, either go up by 3 or go up by 1 in the next bow. Sean Berry is the leadoff batter for the Expos in the third against the lefty Merker. The result is 6-6, which is single 1-8. Line out the rest of the way. Lazo steps in front of that one and makes the catch. 1 out. Split result was 12. Hill's going to bat. Righty versus right, or lefty in this case. 1-9 is the result, which is a strikeout. 3 straight pitches on the pitcher, I'm sure. Not much of a hitter. Now back to the top of the lineup. Marquise Grissom struck out to lead off the game. Merker kicks and deals. Ground ball to first. First baseman has it. Flips to Merker covering. Side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left in the third for the Expos. They go to the bottom of the third. Score 3-0. Atlanta. Top of the order. The Braves. Roberto Kelly, Jeff Blauser, and then Ryan Klesko. Roll for Kelly is 4-7 against a right-hander that is a POW, or point of weakness for pitcher strikeout, which in my case, I call that a called strike. It has a dot after it's a called strike 3. So called strike 3 on Roberto Kelly. 1 out. Wowzer's role is a 6-9. We had seen that result before with Pendleton. In this case, against a righty, it's a home run 1-7. He is an end power, but a double the rest of the way. The split is a 12, so Wowzer rolls into second base with a stand-up double off the wall. Cusco the batter. Man on second, one out. Catcher's going out to talk to Hill. Try to get him settled down. Getting knocked around here in this third going of game three of this series. 5-6 is the result. A ground ball to third. Third baseman Barry gets it. Checks the runner back. Fires over across the diamond. To Floyd. Two are out. Wowzer remains at second base. Two out. Man on. McGriff is the batter. Justice is on deck. I'm going to pitch very carefully to McGriff. In fact, he's going to put him on with his first base open. He's been tearing up the expo pitching on this. We'll see how this goes because, you know, David Justice is no walk in the park. Two out, two on. Pitch to Justice. The result is 2-8, which is a walk against the righty. Strategy is blown just slightly. Bases are now loaded. With Terry Pendleton homered last time up at the plate. He's batting right against, or left-handed, excuse me, against the right-hander Hill. Normal depth for the infield, with two out. The pitch, the result is a fly ball, 3-7 is the roll. The result is double 1-2 fly ball to the left, 3-20, and the split is a 3. So I described that as a diving catch made out in left field by Rondell White to prevent runs from scoring. Great catch by White. Preserves the inning. No runs, one hit, no errors, three left. Score at the end of three. 3-0 Braves. We head to the top of the fourth. Will Cordero leads off. Cordero, Floyd, and then Walker. Cordero bounced up to Pendleton first time up. The result is 3-8. Three count is great for Cordero, and it's a line single to center field for Cordero to lead off the inning. He's a beast stealer, and Javi put some runs back. Yeah, so it's a 1-14 chance with Floyd at the plate down by 3. Not running. Floyd the batter swings, hits a shot, shortstop. Wowzer has it, flips over to Lemke for one, Lemke to McGriff for two, double play. Might have could have wanted to go steal a base there, but they're doubled up, two out, nobody on now for Walker. Lefty versus lefty in this scenario. Walker swings, the result is 2-5, which on Walker's card is triple 1-11, double the rest of the way. Split is an 8, so he bangs a triple. All the more reason maybe to have run on that. But, two out triple by Walker puts a man at third. And Rondell White, the batter, lined out. His first time up. Pitch to White. 6-10 is the result. Ground ball X to third. Pendleton, is a 2. The result is a ground out to third. No runs, two hits, no errors, a man left. No score for the Expos after 4. Braves coming to bat. Bottom of the fourth. Javi Lopez is the batter. Bottom third of the lineup for the Braves. Lopez righty versus righty. Singled last time up. Result is 4-8, which is a ground ball to first, unassisted. Floyd has it, steps on the bag, and there's one out. Mark Lemke, the batter. He flew out to left last time. 6-11 is the result. He's batting left-handed against the right-handed throwing Hill. The result is triple 1, double, 2-20. Split is a 16, so Lemke bangs a double. Stand-up double. Potential for a triple, but rounded and held the bag. Marker the batter, not a good punter, not a good hitter. See if he can hit a ball to the right side. 2-7 as a result on the pitcher's card, which is a strikeout. Bill Red back and fired one past him. Two are out now, man on second base. Lemke's a decent runner. 1-11 chance. Comes 1-13 with two out. Expos outfielder, you don't want to hit it to, well, Moises is on the bench now. So, they're all fair game out there. Roberto Kelly, fly ball to the left. Left fielder White comes in, makes the catch. Side retires. No runs, one hit, no errors, man left. Score 10-4 complete. Braves are up by 3-0. Lenny Webster will lead off the fifth for the Expos. Webster's catching today against the left-hander. Fletcher's getting the day off. Pitch to Lenny. He draws a walk. 3-3 is the result, which is a walk against lefties on Webster's card. Mike Lansing, the batter. Bounced the second last time up. Markers allowed the two hits in the past inning. Expos have left two men on base. Pitch to Lansing. The result is 2-7, which is a single, two stars against lefties. Webster makes it third. First and third, nobody out for Barry. Going to go with the infield back. Trying to get an out here in a double play. Barry's got good power against lefties. The result is 5-10, which is flat, soft fly ball to center field. Center fielder Kelly comes in, makes the catch. There's one out. Brings up the pitcher. He's a right-handed batter, Ken Hill. Hill's going to swing away. The result is 2-7, which is a strikeout. Bullpen's been a little banged up in this series. I'm going to let Hill go. Hill will start to go a little longer. So first and third, two out now for Marquise Grissom. Pitch to Grissom. 4-12 is the result, which is a walk on Merker's card. And bases are now jammed. Will Cordero. He flew out to the base of the fence in yesterday's game against Bedrosian. Expos are mounting a comeback. We'll see how he fares here in the fifth. Two on, or bases loaded, two out. Pitch to Cordero. 5-7 is the result, which is a called strike three. Stood there like a house beside the road and watched that one go by. No runs, one hit, no errors, three left. No score for the Expos through five. Bottom of the fifth, down on tap. Jeff Blauser, the hitter for the Braves, doubled his last trip, 1-2. Little kicks and deals. The result is 4-9, a bounce short. Cordero has it on easy hop, flips it over to first, one away. Ryan Klesko, the batter, left-hander, infield and outfield around toward right. Dead pull hitter. The result is 3-7, a chopper to second base. Lansing has it. Floyd has it as well. There are two away. Two up, two down. Pretty quick inning for Hill. Fred McGriff, the batter. Single and an intentional walk to his credit today. Scored a run back in the second. Cummings homer. Long fly, deep right field. Back, way back, and it is gone. A home run for Fred McGriff. Third of the series, won a game thus far, and the score is now 4-0 Braves. As I said, Hill has had an issue with giving up the long ball, though historically in that series or season he did not. He's just not had the luck of the dice with him. Justice the batter now, 3-10 is the result. Fly ball to center field. Grissom under it, makes the catch. Side retires. Braves get one run on one hit. No errors, nobody left. Scores the end of five complete. Braves are up. 4-0. Merker's cruising right along. Did load the bases this last inning. in the sixth now. His point of weakness inning is the seventh. He'll face Cliff Floyd. Floyd's pretty good hitter against left-handers as a left-handed batter. He bounces a shortstop. Blows it to McGriff, and there's one away. Larry Walker, the batter. Walker tripled his last time up. Stranded there as Murphy got the last out of the inning. Fly ball left field, not deep. Two away. Result was 3-10. Rondell White, the batter. White's a right-hander against the left-hander Murphy. The result is 5-10, which is fly ball center field. Soft fly ball. Roberto Kelly comes in, makes that catch. Side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left in the sixth for the Expos. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Braves lead 4-0. Hamilton will lead off. He hit a three-run homer back in the second. Flew out to left in the third. 1-for-2. Three big RBIs in this game, though. Pendleton, the result, batting left-handed against Hill, is 6-5, which is a called strike 3. One away. Javi Lopez is the batter. Javi's 1-for-2, single, bounced first. 4-6 is the result, which is another called strike 3. Hill's really got the changeup working, freezing him at the plate. Two out, nobody on for Lemke. Lemke doubled last time up, batting left-handed against the right-hander. The result is a pop to third. Third baseman Sean Berry settles under that one, puts it away. The side retires. 1-2-3 inning for the Braves in the sixth. Nothing across. After six complete, 4-0 Braves. We've reached the point of weakness inning for Marker. Should he allow 3 hits or walks in any combination, or 4 over the next 2. Lenny Webster is the batter. He walked his last time up. The Expos have been late charging results, or scoring runs in the late innings, I should say, in the replay. In this case, Webster, the result is a 6-3 single to center field off the pitcher's card. Not much of a runner. 1-9 opportunity, dead E for stealing. So he's just gonna kind of sit there and get pushed around the bases here. Mike Lansing, the batter, 1-for-2. The result is 4-7, which is a walk on Merker's card. Starting out a little rocky. He hasn't given up a run, but he's let the first two on here in his point of weakness inning, the seventh. Brings up Sean Berry. If you're an Expo fan, this is a good opportunity for Berry. Good power against lefties. And looks like the Braves are getting into their bullpen up. Looks like it's Stacy. Let's tell you exactly what it is. Nope, it is Mike Bielecki and Mike Stanton are up and throwing, righty and lefty. Bielecki and Stanton up throwing for the Braves. Two on, nobody out for Berry. See Bunter, pitcher coming up. I don't see him bunting. I see him swinging for the fences. Result is 6-7, which is a hop to second. Second baseman is Lemke. The split is a 2, however, and the result is an infield hit for Berry to load the bases. We're going to get a pinch hitter for Ken Hill. He'll be done for the day. And that pinch hitter will be we're going to go with Randy Milligan. Milligan's hitting in the mid-20s, but he's had some opportune hits for the Expos in this replay. Righty versus lefty matchup. Milligan hasn't got a ton of playing time because he's playing behind Walker. But shining opportunity for him to earn some play time. Milligan the batter, bases are loaded, the infield is back, looking for a double play ball. Merker, as a result of that single, has reached his point of weakness. Both ends up throwing harder now. The result is a 1-4 fly ball to right field, short fly to right. There's an opportunity for the runners to run, but it's Webster. He doesn't take a chance on it. 1-9 with Justice throwing, made it a 1-8 opportunity. Short fly to right by Milligan. Bases are still loaded, now one out. Marquise Grissom, the batter. Merker is still out there chucking. And the bullpen is up. The result is 1-7, which is right in the middle of all the hits on the one card. But the split is a 1 as well, so we'll solve that first of all. So wild pitch opportunity 1-8 for Merker. Split result is a 4, so we do get a wild pitch. Runners are now first, or second and third with a run in. And the pitch result to Grissom is a ground ball B to the pitcher. Ground ball B to the pitcher, though the infield is back, I play it as though it's a check and then throw. So runners remain where they are. Merker gets the ball, fires over to first. Two out, runners on second and third. Cordero's the batter. Merker is still at his point of weakness. He remains in the game to face Cordero. Pitch to Cordero. 4-7 as a result, which is another walk, which loads the bases. And I'm telling you, Cox has seen enough. He's going to go out and get his young left-hander. Merker's out of the game. He went 6 2/3, gave up just a single run on 5 hits. The lefty, Mike Stanton, will come in to face Cliff Floyd. Pitcher's up, due up next for the Braves in the next inning, so it's a one and done potentially for Stanton. Merker, as I said, 6 2/3, gave up 5 hits. He walked 1, 2, 3, 4 batters, hit another, struck out 4, two of those being the pitcher Hill. He did throw a wild pitch, did benefit from a double play, did not allow a home run of course, and that was his 29th batter face. 15, 19, 20, so 9 is the end result. We have 10 guys getting on base with a double play, makes it 9. We bounce. Cliff Floyd is the batter. Bases are loaded, 2 are out. Floyd, the lefty, will stay in against Stanton, the lefty. Or will he? They have Merker. We're going to go with a pinch hitter. Lefty Floyd is out. Juan Bell will come in and bat. For Floyd, Milligan will take over at first base. Bell's pinch hitter. So the 3 spot will become the pitcher spot. Milligan, pinch hitter, will take over at first base. Base is loaded. 2 are out. Juan Bell off the bench to pinch hit. Mike Stanton is the pitcher. The roll is 5-3, which is fly ball right field X. Right fielder is Justice, who's a 3. And the split is 13, so it goes to his X rating. I don't think it's very good out there. Justice is a 16 in right field. This is not good for the Braves. But the high result is a 10, which equates to an E2 in right. So came in, tried to make the one-handed grab, coming in toward the infield, heading for the bench. Doesn't make the catch, 2 runs score. Cordero ends up at third, Bell at second, Larry Walker the batter. Got Rondell White on deck. Lefty versus lefty, they're going to choose to pitch to Walker. Stanton kicks and deals. The result is 6-6, which is a strikeout. So a strikeout Walker with two men in scoring position. But the Expos get three runs on 1-2 hits. One big error. There were two left. Top of the seventh. They put up a three spot, crooked number. Next score is now 4-3. Pitcher spots up for the Braves. Stanton is out. Bielecki will be the pitcher. Warmed up in the bullpen and will come in relief. And the pinch hitter, I gotta get a pitcher for the Expos too. In this case, it's gonna be Tim Scott. He was up throwing, you know, after the pinch hitter Milligan had batted. Tim Scott will come in. The righty at the out on the mound, Tony Tarasco will be the pinch hitter for the Braves. Let's get things settled in here. Finish that inning. We go to the bottom of the seventh. Score is now 4-3. Tarasco, pinch hitter for the Braves. New pitcher for the Expos is Scott. Hill went 6 innings, gave up 7 hits, 4 runs. All 4 were earned on a pair of home runs. He walked 1, another intentionally. He struck out 5, 2 in that last frame that he worked. No hit by pitch, wild pitches. He did have the double play by the pitcher, marker that hit into, and he faced 26 batters. 18 outs, 26 batters, 8 is the end result. Got 9 reaching base with a double play to balance. Tony Tarasco the batter, lefty versus righty. Pitch to Tarasco, 3-6 is the result, fly ball left field. Let's see, I've got to go back and take a look here at the left-hander we have in for the Braves. We had Stanton in. The split result was a 1 on that throw. Stanton is a 4, wild pitch. 3 is the result. We're backing up. So, prior to the inning ending with Walker's flyout, Stanton threw a wild pitch, which allowed Cordero to score. And the score is tied at 4. You do go back and audit, especially on the 1s and 2s. You can see I have the dice colored to tell me if there's a result that can result in a wild pitch or a balk. I didn't catch it, but that split result did not lie. We are tied going to the bottom of the seventh. So the result now is 3-6 against Tarasco, which is a fly ball to left field. Left fielder White put that one away. Roberto Kelly the batter. 1 out, nobody out. 1-7 is the throw, which is just above 1-8 home run for Kelly, but it's a fly ball to center field, not deep. Center fielder Grissom squeezes that one. There are 2 away. 2 out, 2 nobody on. A couple fly balls off the bats of the Braves. Jeff Bowser 1-for-3. He doubled. Reached third back in the third. Failed to score. The result The dice result is 111, which is a ground ball to third. A, Barry has it. Over now, first baseman Milligan. Side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors, nothing left in the seventh for the Braves. Top of the eighth, we're tied at four. So big error and wild pitch by the Braves put the Expos back in the game. As I said, Mike Bielecki will be the reliever. In the top of the eighth, Bedrosian's out throwing in the bullpen. He's been in the two previous innings, or two previous games. So if he came into this game, he would be automatically at his point of weakness. All four runs that were scored by the Expos in that inning were charged to Merker. Only one of them were earned. Two runs scored on wild pitches, I now recount. So two wild pitches and an outfield error tie the game for the Expos. Rondell White, the batter. Righty versus righty. 110 is the result, which is a triple, 1 through 16, double, 17 through 20. And White rolls into third with a slide ahead of the throw triple to lead off the eighth. Lenny Webster is the man up. Fletcher's knee taking the day off. Webster will bat righty versus righty. Usually he's platooned out, but in this case he's going to bat. Both ends up and throwing. Bedrosian might come in sooner. I also have McDowell throwing out there in the pen. McMichael is pitching. So it's Bedrosian, McMichael up throwing. Runner on third. Braves are going to bring the infield in. Lenny Webster, the batter. We need a fly ball to go ahead. Or a base hit, of course. 4-10 is the result, which is on the catcher's card. Javi is a 4. 14 is the split roll. The way I play the catcher is this. If the result is a wild pitch or a pass ball, that is the result for this roll. And the batter bats again. In this case, it is a pass ball. So once again, though nobody's knocked the run in, the Expos score on the pass ball. Webster's still at the plate. So pass ball charge to Javi. White scores. Scores now 5-4. Expos. Nobody out here in the eighth. Webster's batting. 3-3 is the result, which is a single to left field. Michael's getting ready to come in. Cox is standing on the top step. Webster's an E stealer. I like he's a plus 9 and the catcher's a plus 2. Ooh, goody, woody. 7 plus 3, 1 through 12. No, we're not going to run. Lansing swings and hits a ground ball to short. Blauser is a 3. Split is a 16. They get the force at second base, and that's all they'll get. Hard slide by Webster kept them from getting Lansing at first. One out. Lansing now the runner. He is a B stealer. Makes him a 1 to 18 chance. He's going to go. He has stolen that base easily. So a man on second base. Sean Berry is the batter. Cox is going to go out and get his pitcher. Galecki's out. McMichael's coming in. Mark Wohlers takes his spot in the bullpen. Bedrosian's soft tossing right now. Not throwing hard. They now are a run down. McMichael will come in. And he'll face Sean Berry. That lucky faced three batters. Give up two hits. Has a run against him currently. Berry will bat. Milligan, the first baseman, is on. Pitch Sean Barris, 1-7 is the result, which is a bounce to shortstop A. Glauser has it, checks the runner back. Lansing at second base, throws over to McGriff, and there's two away. I have to retrieve Milligan because I'd put him in the discard pile until I made that choice. Milligan, righty versus righty, will bat, two out, and on second base. Nice to get another insurance run here. The result is 1-5, which is a strikeout on Milligan's card. So McMichael comes in and does the job, retiring two. They get one run on two hits. No errors, there's a man left. After 7.5, score is now 5-4, Expos. Tim Scott on the mound for the Expos. John Weddlin, up throwing in the bullpen along with Dennis Booker. Righty and lefty up for the Expos as we go to the bottom of the eighth. Scott does fairly well against lefties. Hopefully we get some pitcher's card rolls here. 5-9 is the roll, which is a strikeout versus lefties. Scott retires Klusko on a strikeout swing. Fred McGriff, the batter. Prime Dog is already homered, singled in this game, an intentional walk otherwise. Base is empty, nobody on, with one out. That's where you want to face him. Let's see if we can get him out. 6-10 is the result. Fly ball center field X. Center fielder is Grissom, who's a 1, and the split result is a 1. So in that case, I also call that a diving catch in center field. So McGriff is robbed by Grissom out in center field. Two away, David Justice, the batter. Right through the heart of the lineup, Klusko, Griffin, McGriff, and Justice. Two out, nobody on for Scott. The result is 4-6, which is a pop-up to first base. First baseman Milligan over. Makes the catch by the railing, and the Braves go quietly in the eighth. No runs, no hits, no errors, nobody left. We go to the top of the ninth. The Expos lead, 5-4. McMichael's still in as a pitcher. Batter is Grissom. The pitcher, Scott, is due up third in this inning. And we're getting a pinch hitter, it looks like. Looks like Frazier's getting a bat. So Weddlin will come in the ninth, trying to preserve the win. Grissom leads off with a 6-9 roll, which is a fly ball center field. Roberto Kelly puts that one away. Fairly deep, but he had plenty of room out there in center field here. Fulton Stadium put it away. Will Cordero, the batter, one out, nobody on. Cordero scored on a wild pitch back in the seventh. Tied the score at 4. Results 2-7. A strikeout on Cordero's card. 2 up, 2 down. McMichael's doing his job. And pitcher Scott is up. Scott's going to come out. Did a great job of preserving the right lead. Lou Frazier will be the pinch hitter. And as expected, John Weddlin, who has 26 saves thus far in the replay, looking for number 27, will come on in the ninth. Lou Frazier, 2 out, nobody on. He's announced into the game. Lou has been tearing it up, hitting 350 and knocking in a fair amount of runs. See how he does here against McMichaels, who's been throttling him. Bounce to second base. Lemke's got it. Quick toss over to McGriff and the side retires. No runs, no hits, no errors. Nobody left in the ninth. We go to the bottom of the ninth. With a score 5-4 Expos. Terry Pendleton will lead it off against Weddlin. Scott went two innings, two perfect innings, I should say, with a strikeout to hold the Braves at bay. Hamilton, the batter, he homered back in the second. Three-run job. Put the Braves up at that time. Seemed insurmountable, but some bad pitching and bad fielding in the seventh. Put the Expos back in the game. The roll is 5-6 on the pitcher's card. In this case, the split is triple 1 through 2, fly ball to center field. So it's, the split is an 8. The catch is made by Grissom out there. In the mind's eye, that's a running catch. Could have been a triple if it had been a few feet farther. So fine running catch out in center field by Grissom. And the first out is made. Javi Lopez, the batter. Lemke's on deck. The pitch to Javi. 6-6 is the result, which is on the pitcher's card. Single 1 through 6. The split is a 2, so Lopez singles to center field. Javi's going to get run 4. Mike Kelly, bench runner. He's a 1-15 opportunity on the base paths. So Mike Kelly will come in and pinch run for Lopez. Javi's 2-for-4 today. Pinch hitter for Lemke will be the catcher, Charlie O'Brien. Bill Picotta. Winding his glove on the base, on the bench. He's going to come in and take the empty spot at second base. So Charlie O'Brien gets an opportunity. He will come into the game as the catcher should the game continue. Currently he's just a pinch hitter with a man on first. Lemke was 1-for-3. O'Brien gets Quedlin. The strategy is looking for the long ball. O'Brien is a home run hitter. Lemke is not. Similar batting averages. Kelly getting his lead over at first. I don't expect he's going to run. Let's see what his writing is. Oh, yeah. He's an E-stealer. O'Brien on the batter. Wedlund's looking for a double play ball now. 1-9 is the result, which is a strikeout on the pitcher's card. Wedlund reared back and threw one by him. Pitcher spot is up now. We'll get a pinch hitter. McMichael's day is done. He came on and did a great job keeping the Expos off the board for further damage. And the pinch hitter will be Jose Oliva. Oliva has on his card 1-4, 1-5, 1-6, 1-9, 1-10, 1-12 home runs. Those are all home run results against right-handers. In the 94 season, he only had 59 at-bats, but he cracked 6 homers, 11 RBI. So Cox is going all out, hoping Oliva can knock one over the fence and make this a Braves win instead of a Expo win. Two are out, Weddle in the batter, the pitcher. Kelly getting his lead at first, the pitch. The result is 3-11, bounce to short. Shortstop Cordero has it, flips over to Lansing, side retires, game is over. No runs, one hit, no errors, a man left. And the final score of game 100 of the 1994 replay of the Expos season is a 5-4 victory for the Expos. Now, 3-game lead over the Braves. Thanks for watching. I'll give you a recap here shortly.